Hi there, welcome back. Let's talk about functions. So for this video, you'll be learning on the pseudocode to define and use a function as well as functions with or without parameter. First of all, function is also known as subprogram or subroutines. It means that it's a modular approach to problem design and coding. Block of code needs to be written once and the code can then be repeatedly executed. And you have to remember that a function has a function header with an identifier name, a specific data type, parameters can be none, one or more, and it always returns a single value. So returning a single value is the biggest difference between functions and procedures. So how do you define a function without parameter? So first of all, you're right, function identifier returns data type. So identifier is the name of the function and data type is the type of the data that you will return from the function. And next, within the function, we will write statement here and finally end function. And next will be how to define a function with parameter. So the first line will be function identifier, bracket parameter 1, data type, comma parameter 2, data type, and etc. returns data type. So if you look at this, it actually looks quite similar to the function without parameter. It's just that right now we have this extra bracket here with the parameter name as well as the data type. So this is the difference between without parameter and with parameter. And next will be the same, which is statement, and then finally end function. So just a gentle reminder, we always write the statement inside the function. So it means that the statement can never be the same indentation as the function. So let's look at this function, and then we have a tab here, and then end function. So function and end function share the same indentation, but the statement is always inside the function. So just remember that. Now let's look at some function example. So create a function which converts a temperature from Fahrenheit to Celsius. So it means that for this function, the input will be Fahrenheit and we will return Celsius degree from this function. So function convert far to cell and the input will be temp in Fahrenheit as a real number returns real. So for the function name, instead of writing convert Fahrenheit to Celsius, we just make it a bit shorter to convert far to cell. And we also know that temperature always has decimal, therefore we use real number. And for this example, the statement is actually quite straightforward. We just have to write return temp in Fahrenheit, which is this input here, minus 32 bracket here, and then divided by 1.8 to get Celsius. And finally, we will just end the function just like that. So let's do a quick recap on function definition. So first of all, we have function here, and then a function name, and an input name, and an input data type. What to return from this function, and the data type, which is real number here, and then the return statement within the statement inside, as well as the end function here. And next, let's look at how can we call and use the function. So first of all, input temp in Fahrenheit means that you'll type in the Fahrenheit degree into the console, and then it will be stored as the temp in Fahrenheit variable. And then temp in Celsius will be equal to convert far to cell, and then we'll pass in the input variable, which is temp in Fahrenheit for this use case. So it means that the output from this function will be stored into this temp in Celsius variable. And finally, we'll just output temp in Celsius. So this is how you can create a basic function based on a given problem statement, call, and then use the function. So before I end the video, I have a question for you just to test your understanding and progress so far. So the question will be, write pseudocode for an algorithm to implement your own version of the meet function, which will operate in the same way as shown in the insert, using right and left function from the insert. So this question is asking, inside the insert, we have this meet function here, which returns a string of length y starting at position x from this string. So let's look at an example, meet A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, 2, 3 will return B, C, D. So why B, C, D? Because it says that it starts from index 2 with 3 characters. So let's look at this, index 1, index 2. So this index 2 is the starting position, and then 3 characters, so it will be 2, 3, 4. Therefore, the answer is B, C, D. So this is the function of meet function based on the insert. And this question wants you to implement the exact same thing using right and left function, which is also from the insert itself. So the right function will be returns rightmost x characters from this string. So for example, right a, b, c, d, e, f, g, h, 3 will return f, g, h because from the right 3 characters, so it will be 1, 2, 3. Therefore, the answer is f, g, h. And then for the left function, returns leftmost x characters from this string. Therefore, left a, b, c, d, e, f, g, h, 3 will return a, b, c because 1, 2, 3 from the left. So this question is asking you to implement a function using this right and left function from the insert. So how do you do this? You might get a bit lost because you are just teaching some basic function definition and calling the function. And this question looks a bit complicated, but no worries. Let me give you some helpful prompts to do this question. So the first one would be, what is the input and output for this function? So for this question, the input and output have been given to you already because they are just asking you to copy the mid function. So let's look at the mid function. So this mid has this input 1, input 2 and input 3, and this is the output. So for your own version of the mid function, you can just copy everything from this mid function here because we are using the same input and the same output. So for the second prompt, what should be the logic? So to implement mid function, what you can do here is that you can first read from the right and then read from the left. So using this function, reading from the right and then reading from the left, you should be able to implement the same thing as mid function. So for example, let's say I want to get DEFs. What I do here is that I will read H, G, F, D, E, F first from the right. And then after that, I'll implement the left function, which will read 3 characters from the left. So 3 characters, D, E, F. So using this method, I can actually get D, E, F. So this is one of the logic that you can implement. And the final point will be, what are the variables? So for this function, most probably you need maybe 2 to 3 variables. So the first variable that I can think of is most probably the length of the string. So it means that you have to calculate the length of input string to play around with the position. And the second one most probably will be the output string, because we are returning the output string here. So it means that at the middle of the statement, most probably you have to do some manipulation to the output string in order to return the correct output string. So this is a question and the helpful prompts for this suitable question. Definitely in the comment section below, just try your best and let us know your answer. Thank you, and I'll see you again then. Bye bye.